to talk about Villains Month, which is very exciting. Yeah, so Kimberly's done a lot of research, so she's going to say a little bit about what you guys should expect.
Well, the cool thing is that we have this Trinity War going on, and in the end, it's like, all the superheroes are gone and vanquished and dead, which is a sad day, but a happy day for the villains. The villains take over the DC Universe. The cool thing is that they each get their own special cover. And what I really liked about it is they show their hero. So like for Poison Ivy, yay. They have like the Detective Comics written, and then they have it like X'd out, and then they write Poison Ivy on top of it, and then so everybody gets their own awesome cover. They're releasing a couple of 3D covers. Those are special editions, so you guys better order them fast.
You can see an example of all the covers.
They have pictures of all the covers.
And what, the new ones this week?
Right. Yeah, the new ones this week.
This one's Batman and Nightwing, issue 23.
So most of them that are coming out will have little miniatures. And if you go on the DC website, then they have a little blurb about every single one with a picture of the cover.
And the way that they did the covers, I'm not sure exactly how the holograph is going to work, but they have, I want to say, like 3 or 4 layers that they've layered over top of each other to create that 3D effect. So I don't know if it's going to be like one of those holographic Pokemon card kind of things.
I was totally about to say that.
Yeah. Or if it's going to be like kind of like a staggered on top of each other picture. But yeah, the people at the comic book store said that our comic book store is really popular, so they have a lot of the 3D covers coming out. But if you're in a smaller comic book area, it's going to be hard.
Order them fast.
Yeah. What was that article that we read about that there's some that are limited more than others?
It had something to do with the fact that the smaller stores, they would put in their order, and they're probably getting about like 5% of what they actually ordered because of how much business they do. That's what I got from that article.
Just for the holographic covers.
Yeah, just for the holographic covers. You'll be able to get all of your issues wherever you are. It's just, if you want a holographic cover, I might start doing research now on where and exactly when you can get them.
They're releasing, maybe 5 or 6 per week. Mm-hmm. And it starts in September.
That should be cool. And they have the Joker's daughter, which is a very interesting one. You said you read one of the interviews on that?
I read an interview with Anne Nocente, who was talking about how she is kind of taking she's kind of making anorexia kind of punk influences to draw this character. But it looks interesting. I think there's a little bit of Harley Quinn in her, but it's more like just a little bit. She looks kind of creepy. It'll be interesting.
It'll be really cool to see how they do it.
Yeah.
Because she's kind of an older character that they're trying to revamp, right?
Because Dula Dent was a very confusing character. Her wiki is all over the place. So
she claimed to have so many different dads. Harvey Dent, the Riddler, Penguin, Catwoman's daughter.
So it'll be interesting to see what they do with this in the new 52.
Yeah. How they untangle all that mess.
Or if they even touch that mess.
They may just do their own character, because it almost sounded like looking at the new 52 channel.
You
said watching.
You have my disease. Let's start looking at the episodes now.
Yeah. So looking at the new 52 channel, it made it almost sound like there was a girl that's cultish that's picked up the Joker's face. That's the vibe I got from it, but that might not necessarily be what's going on.
And the picture, if you look at it, kind of looks like it's just a girl holding up the Joker's face.
Uh-huh.
Which could potentially happen,
because at the end of Death of the Family, his face
did
fall off.
It did.
Down a well or something, right?
Was he in the back?
Yeah,
the waterfall or something.
They
have
a lot of them.
Yeah.
They're all over Gotham, all these waterfalls. It's the biggest tourist attraction.